Welcome to Ascension Parish Coffee Talk, a weekly show where I talk about nothing but Ascension Parish. My name is Kristina Smallhorn, your real estate whisperer for Ascension Parish. On this week's show, I was lucky enough to have Mark Taylor, who runs the Droop Facebook business page. He's a guy who's just decided that he was going to start a page as kind of like a fan page for Droop. I don't know if you know who he is, but he's the guy that rides the bicycle around town, always collecting cans. Well, over the years, that page has grown into something much more than just a fan page. It's grown as kind of a benefit for Droop. And I'm going to have Mark come by the house and talk to us about that page and how it all got started. So I'm here with Mark Taylor, and he started the Droop Facebook page. And I just wanted to know how it all got started. And I know that people of Ascension Parish have seen Droop riding his bicycle around town, but he's kind of got a story, and you have a story to help him along the way. So why don't you share that with us?
Right. In 2009, we had started a Facebook page, the fan page. That's when it first started becoming popular. So, and it started initially kind of as a novelty. So we started the page, and I posted and I sent the link to maybe two people. And then I went to the gym, and then an hour later, I get home and look at it. And he basically has 400 fans within an hour or so. And so it continued at that pace. You know, within 2 or 3 days, he had 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 fans. And within a week, he had about 4,500 fans. The only thing is, a lot of these people actually knew him. So I don't know if it was service members that had, you know, moved to other countries. But nonetheless, he had a pretty impressive following after 1 week. And so it was kind of eye-opening how many people followed him. So.
Right. And he rides his little bike around town, and he doesn't bother anybody. Do you know where he's going to on his bike?
Well, some years ago, I mean, he used to make his rounds and collect cans, and then he would drive his cans sometimes, maybe 25 miles round trip. And he would go 3 or 4 times a week carrying 30 to 40 pounds of cans on the back of his bike. So. Mm-hmm. Now he kind of has this little ritual where he makes his way down, Black Bayou Road, and then on to 44, goes down 44, goes to Rouse and kind of hangs out for a little bit, and then he'll go down the road and go to Chip's Grocery and hang out a little bit there, and then he'll go to Walmart neighborhood supermarket, and then he'll kind of hang out there, and then he'll, you know, bask in the sun for a couple hours, and then when it starts getting close to dark, he rides and makes his way back home.
Well, I know that the page has helped him quite a bit. Like, you've gotten him shirts, and sometimes some people have kind of helped with little fix-its on his house. So how did that get started? I saw that there was like some kind of logo or something you guys had come up with.
Originally it kind of caught fire when the page was created, and then all the fans were added, and next thing you know, And I don't even remember exactly who it was, but somebody suggested, you know, why don't we buy him a bike? And it was getting kind of close to Christmas time. I was like, all right, I don't really know how to do this. I've never been a part of a fundraiser. I don't know how we'll do all this, but okay. And then so it got from people making logos. One of the guys designed several t-shirt designs and said, why don't we do t-shirts? We sell t-shirts.
Right.
I said, all right, well, that's fine. Where are we going to sell them at? You know, and then... I went and spoke with Miss Ann from the Bike Connection, which is, unfortunately, it's no longer open. You know, it closed since then, but, and she's like, man, I can help y'all out, you know, give you her pricing on the bike. And
right.
And also my friend Jesse Rodrigue, he has the I Heart LSU shirts. And
uh-huh.
So he said, man, I can help you with the shirts. So if you get a design, so we ended up, you know, settling on a design, which was pretty cool, kind of a retro look design. And I gave it to Jesse, and he contacted his people. And, you know, after that, we had those shirts produced. We sold every one of the shirts that we had. We sold them so fast that I actually didn't even end up getting a shirt, because I had sold more shirts than I had, you know, because we had set up a link through the page to where we had the PayPal service and all that. So people ordered them, and the next thing you know, we had sold them all out, and we didn't even have any more. But yeah, we sold every shirt that we made. We sold all of them. And that money went to, we bought them a pretty expensive bike, and it was a really nice bike, nicer than any bike that I've ever had, for sure.
Right.
And so we got him that bike, and then also bought him some supplies for that, some clothes, food, we also bought some things to go on the bike as far as like an air pump, you know, extra tubes for the tires because he wears and goes through a lot of tubes, yeah. You know, from all the riding he does. Uh-huh. So it was, you know, numerous items, but all the money that, all the proceeds that were made from the t-shirts, they went back to him or his family in some sort of way.
He doesn't ask for much though. He doesn't ask for anything really.
No, I mean, he's never asked me for anything. And he's also at times turned down things just like, you know, I'm okay. I'm good. But so, you know, it was more or less, we try to make sure that if he breaks down, then somebody can contact me and let me know, hey, look, he's mm-hmm. walking, which has happened, you know, several times. And from there, we're able to, you know, get him some help, you know, get his bike taken care of or mm-hmm. whatever. It really isn't so much about, I'm not trying to raise an excess of funds or monies. And a lot of time I say, don't go out and buy something brand new. If you have something that's gently used or whatever, then we'd be more than glad to take that way. Mm-hmm. But we had people donated also all kinds of items, clothes, shirts, blankets, heaters, man, all kinds of things like that. He just recently got a donation of probably 20 LSU shirts.
I saw that.
And a couple of Saints shirts, and he's just been overjoyed.
Yeah, well, I know that he flooded too, and you helped with some of the recovery for him when he flooded.
Right, the flood came right, actually he had gotten hit by a car. And that was right before the flood happened. So after mm-hmm. the flood happened, we asked one of the family members, does he have somewhere safe to sleep, you know, after he got in his car accident? Well, mm-hmm. What we decided at that point was easy for him to have a chair that he can recline and lay down in and prop right. his feet up, you know. So that's what we did. And we were able to get a donation from somebody that gave him a really nice reclinable chair, and mm-hmm. that helped out through the foot injury. So,
is there anything that he needs now that you could think of that maybe people could donate some things that for him?
You know, if they're people that, especially, he really likes LSU shirts, Saints shirts, any kind of athletic apparel that's you know, sporty. He's a Sanimal fan. I've seen him wearing East Ascension clothes as well. Dutchtown, you know, he likes local sports teams. So
he is a local celebrity. He is.
And so, you know, but that's, if you have excess shirts like that, I mean, I think he wears like a large or an extra large. Mm-hmm. I've seen him wear both. Also, you know, he wears the socks, the kind of like sports socks, soccer socks,
or the ones that come high up. Right.
He also wears
socks.
Yeah,
they're tube socks.
Right. And so, and also like the athletic shorts, almost like PE shorts.
Right. So you said that there was a place that you could drop off some items for him if this anybody wanted to do that. What's that place?
Right. It's the name of it is Trendy Treasures Boutique, and they're located in Gonzales off mm-hmm. of 621 and Casey Road, I believe. And we have it posted on the website, and they have the hours.
The Facebook
business.
Page.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's Trendy Treasures Boutique in Gonzales, and we want to say thank you to them also. But primarily, the main thing is just if you see him out and about, you know, we take pictures and post on the website, you know, mm-hmm. a Droop sighting, so just letting people know where he's at. And it brings a smile to people, so it's pretty good. And then, but the main thing is we want to make sure that if he's really in need, basically that we have a means of communication to say, hey, look, I saw him, he didn't have his bike, or hey, look, he got a flat tire, or whatever. And at that time, then, you know, we can bring him a tube for the bike or mm-hmm. whatever, you know.
So if anybody in town sees him on the side of the road, who should they call? They should call you, right? What's your name?
Well, they can actually, if you post it to the Facebook page, okay. I get that. And, you know, so that's been how it's done primarily. We've seen a lot of people doing some really nice things for him mm-hmm. because I see him a lot of times pass around. You'll see somebody bring him a drink, you know, just a water, you know, because it's hot outside. And or somebody, some kids the other day bought him a snowball, which was a really kind gesture. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, if you see him and he's in distress or anything like that, because he is getting older in age, you know, mm-hmm. You can help out in that kind of way.
He likes the simple things.
Right.
Well, I really appreciate your time and telling us about Droop. And if anybody does see Droop out in the area, please give him a water or just a friendly hello. He's a friendly man and he likes that. So thank you, Mark. I appreciate your time
All right.
today.
Thank you.
I'd like to say a very special thank you to Mark Taylor for talking to us about our favorite local hero, Droop. If you'd like some more information about homes in the Ascension Parish area, you can always visit my website at yourrealestatewhisperer.com. My name is Kristina Smallhorn, your real estate whisperer for Ascension Parish, and I tell you all this because you matter.
One thing I found was funny, other people are like, well, he needs new shoes. He's always wearing mismatched shoes. Get him some new shoes. So I get him some new shoes. And I see him again. He's got to mix and match. Like, he does it on purpose. He does it on purpose. He has to do it on purpose because I just gave him brand new shoes. And he...